Abu Bakr appears and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam inquires to Abu Bakr, "Ma ja'a bika ya Aba Bakr?" And what is it that brought you out, ya Aba Bakr, at this type of hour in the midst of the night? Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa arda wants to teach. He's the great teacher. In Jahiliyyah, he was known as the Shaykh. In Islam, whilst the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is alive, he's known as the Shaykh radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa arda. What does Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu wa arda say, teaching each and every single one of us? He says radiallahu ta'ala anhu, "Kharajtu min bayti," that I exited my house, "kay anzur ila wajhi Rasulillah," just to gaze at the face of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And at this point we pause and we reflect. Since when have we ever inside of our heart the type of yearning to gaze upon the blessed face of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam? Because if they don't teach us the great cosmic theology, aqidah, of the people of Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the likes of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, famen, then who will teach us that type of reality? And when? And in the type of yearning that Sayyidina Asma bint Umays, radiallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha, the blessed wife of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, would say that Abu Bakr in the midst of the night would be crying, screaming, "Wa shawqah li Rasulillah, wa shawqah li Rasulillah," calling out, yearning out for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is the average night of Abu Bakr. And they say that the only thing that could shackle Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda was when the great woman Sayyidina Asma would tell him that you're of those who gave victory to the Messenger of Allah, that your relationship with the Messenger of Allah is sealed and he is pleased with you because you are pleased with him. He said that's the only thing that would stop the yearning, the crying of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. What type of man is he who in the midst of his house is yearning for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, a type of feeling that forces him out of his house at a quote unquote ungodly hour? But every hour of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is godly, is holy, is lordly, and he goes out of his house radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda. But look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yata'amal ma'a, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deals with the greatest Siddiq al-Akbar, that when he walks out of his house, what does he see? The face of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama. The sha'n, the affair is sha'n al-mahabba, it's an affair of love. And our ulama radiallahu ta'ala anhum wa ardahum, they say love is imbued in the heart of a human being based upon husn wal ihsan. Beauty, external beauty, wal ihsan, internal beauty. Two things that are needed in order to what? To procure, to engender, to imbue love inside of the heart of a human being. And the face of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam is absolute perfect beauty, if we can use such a term. Because the reality of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inwardly and outwardly, لا يعرفني إلا الله. Only Allah ta'ala knows me. He said sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. You know, some of the ulama radiallahu ta'ala anhum wa ardahum, they say when you speak about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being characterized by absolute perfection, khata, you're erroneous, it's wrong. Allah is not characterized by absolute perfection. Why? Because your definition of perfection is your definition of perfection. Limited. Allah Ta'ala is absolved from perfection. Absolved, subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ta'rifu. You don't know Allah Jalla Jalalahu wa ta'ala ta'azamatu. Likewise, you don't know the Messenger of Allah unless you are Allah.